Welcome to Wall Street Mojo. To know about this video, AGGREGATE Excel Function, watch the video till the end. And also, if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given. Welcome, everyone. So let's begin with today's topic. See, AGGREGATE Function in Excel is categorized basically as a math or a trig function. It was introduced in Excel closely around in 2010, and it performs, you know, specified operations and returns an aggregate in a list or a database. Okay, so that is a scenario here. AGGREGATE Function Excel, it allows the functions like, you know, count, you have average, sum, max, or probably min by ignoring the errors and the hidden rows. Well, we'll start with aggregate. And once you do that, you have different number of things available in front of you. But, you know, just don't start with that. Those are just the names, the name box names. You have a couple of things here. See, there are two types of syntax of aggregate form. One is the reference syntax. So, and other is the array. Okay, array syntax. So the function num is a number that denotes a specified function that we want to use, and it is a number from 1 to 19. Now, there are different types of numbers, like, you know, for 1, it is average, 2 for count, 3 for count A, 4 for max, and so on and so forth. So, option, it is over here that, you know, it is a numerical value over here. I'm talking about the option, it is a numerical value ranging from 0 to 7. And it determines which value are to be ignored and which calculations are to be done. It's like 0 is like, you know, ignore nested subtotal aggregate function, 2 is aggregate values, and so on and so forth. And there is reference 1, it's called ref 1. Then we have ref 2 and then ref 3. So it is the argument while using the reference syntax, it is a numerical value or the value which we want to perform the computation, and at least 2 arguments are required. Rest arguments are just optional. Next we have is the array. An array is a value which we want to perform the operation. It is used in the array syntax of the aggregate function in Excel. So k in an optional argument and is numerical value. It is used when the function like large, small, percentile, quartile, percentile inc, or quartile x inc are used. How to use the aggregate function in Excel? Well, let's look at some of the examples of aggregate Excel function Excel. And these aggregate function Excel examples will help you in exploring the use of the aggregate function in Excel. We'll start with example number 1, showing the function. Suppose we have a list of the numbers and we will compute the average. Count that, you know, is the number of the cells that contain value. So count and count of cells that are not empty. So maximum, minimum products and some of the given numerical values. Values are given somewhat like this over here. Well, once we have this, we can start computing different functions. The first one is the average. Well, what we can do is use the function is equal to aggregate, and first we are going to use is average. So in column C you have all these numbers, all of them are given, you know, given below, and we won't have to ignore any value. So we'll select the option number 4, ignoring nothing. So we can also select like max, we can select 4. Now once you have selected this, just before that, select the function number, that is 1, comma, 4, ignore nothing, okay. Then, after doing that, comma, select the whole array here, close the bracket, you have the average, and then select the whole thing and control R. Now, this is showing a value error and some are showing. So over here, since the k here, the k is the optional argument and is used when the function like large, small, percentile, quartile, and so on and so forth are used. Now similarly for the range of D1 to D8, again we'll select the option number 4. And for the range E1 to E8, a cell E6 contains an error value. So if we will use the same aggregate formula, we will get an error. But when an appropriate option is used, the aggregate in Excel gives the average of the remaining values, neglecting the error value probably in the E6 value here, that is div0 function. So in order to ignore this value, we have option number 6. So in the similar fashion, you can calculate for all of them. Similarly, for the range from G1 to G8, we will use an option number 6, ignore the error values. So what will happen here? Ignore the error values. Okay, you select that. Now, for the range for H3, this one, if you put a value of 64 and hide the third row and they use the option number 5 to ignore the hidden rows, the aggregate in Excel, we will give an average value for the visible numerical values only. So that may seem appropriate over here. Now the output of hiding row number 3, that makes sense. And applying the aggregate formula for the other operations, we have different sort of an answer. This is 1, just keep following and you will keep getting different sort of answers here on. Right, so this is a function number and everything is selected, so you do not need to worry. Now, suppose this is example number 2. Suppose we have a table for the revenue generated on different dates from the different channels, and the date and channels are given. You have been given the revenue. So now we want to check the revenue generated for different channels. So when we apply this sum function, we get the total revenue generated. But in case if we want to check the revenue generated for organic channel here, you know, in that particular scenario, you know, or direct channel or any other, when we apply filter in Excel for the same, the sum function will always give the total sum. Now, how we are going to do? It is as simple as that. You do not need to worry. Either you do the sum here, just calculate sum, and you have the answer. So we want that when we filter the channel, we get the sum of the values that are visible. And so instead of using the sum function, we will use the aggregate in Excel. And in order to get the sum of the values that are visible when a filter is applied, so replacing the sum formula with the aggregate function Excel with option code number 5, you can use that. You can use the option code number 5. So how you're going to do that? Well, we'll start with is equal to aggregate. In that, select the sum, comma, we'll say ignore the hidden rows, comma, C2 to C11, bracket close, and you have the answer. Okay, if you have any hidden rows, they will hide it. Now, when we will apply the filter for the different channel, it will show revenue for the channels only as the rest of the rows gets hidden, and the total revenue generated for the direct channel. Okay, that you need to do with the filter. Now, the total revenue generated for the organic channel also. So, you see over here, if you just select the organic, you'll just get the answer for the organic. Okay. And the total revenue generated by paid channels is somewhere close to 18,824. So we can use the aggregate in function Excel that because that computes the different sum values for the revenue generated for different channels once they are filtered. So the aggregate function Excel can be dynamically used for replacement of different functions for different condition without using the conditional formula. And suppose for the same table, channel and revenue sum of or revenue values, it contains error. We need to ignore the errors, and at the same time, if you want to apply a filter, the aggregate in Excel should ignore the hidden values also. Okay, So when we use the option number 5, we get the error for the sum of the total revenue. And in order to ignore the error, we have to use the option number 6. Just the same thing here. Instead of this, I'll use 6 and it will give me. So option 6, we get the sum ignoring the error values. But when we apply the filter for the example, filter by channel, value direct, we get the same sum ignoring the errors. But at the same time, we have to ignore the hidden values also at the same time. So in this case, we will use the option number 7 that ignores the error values and at the same time, the hidden rows. What are the some of the things that you should remember about the aggregate function Excel? See, the aggregate function in Excel does not recognize the function num value that is greater than 19 or less than 1, and similarly for option number, it does not recognize the value that is greater than 1. So if you provide any other values, it gives a value error. It always accepts the numerical value and it always returns a numerical value as an output. Now these aggregate in Excel has limitation and it only ignores the hidden rows, okay, but does not ignore the hidden columns. That's it for this particular video. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like, comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you, everyone.